morning. It is so gloomy outside today here. I know a lot of you guys are way worse off with like the ice storms and stuff, but I just feel like it's like already nighttime. It's so weird. But I've had a pretty productive morning. I got up early and I did a lot of the work that I needed to get done. I went into Yo and I came back. And now I'm getting ready to go into Jewel. I don't know if you guys can see it here. Yeah, I'm getting ready to go into Jewel to get a couple of things. I want to make some roasted vegetables today, and I've been to like 3 different stores over the last couple of days and they have not had zucchini anywhere. So I'm hoping that Jewel has it and I can get some zucchini. I need to get a red onion. I already have peppers, and I have Brussels sprouts, and I just want to like roast a bunch of vegetables and eat that. I might even make like a meatless taco on like lettuce wraps or something. That's what I was thinking about having today for lunch or dinner. So hopefully I can find what I need. We'll see what other shenanigans I get into in here. But I'm just gonna go home and just try to keep cleaning up the house. It just like gives me a little bit of anxiety living in this like filth, you know? It feels like it's filth, even though I know it's not. But I'm sure you guys, if you've done remodeling in your house, you totally understand where I'm coming from there. It's not like, I mean, trust me, I'm so grateful and I feel so blessed that this is even going on. But it just feels weird, you know, for that little bit of time that you have to live in it. So I'm hoping I can get that shop back to work a little bit better. My dad gave me some tips on how to like clean it out, so hopefully I can do that. But I just need to run in now and grab this. Hopefully my glasses don't get all rained on and they have everything I need. What I needed. They have a beautiful produce section in Jewel. Like, I really, really like it. The only thing is, like, the sticker shock for me is crazy because I'm so used to Aldi prices that it's just so weird when I buy produce elsewhere. I'm like, oh my gosh, it's so much more expensive. And I would say probably like the rest of the store isn't awesome, but the produce section is a win. So most of my thumbnails just come from a screenshot from the video, and I'm looking for a thumbnail from yesterday's video. And I mean, like, what is that? I just always find the most random screenshots. I could land on anything and it's awkward. You know what I mean? It's so funny. I just can't believe some of my facial expressions. So I'm heading out to Target. I'm leaving again to go get, I want to look for this file organizer for like my tax receipts, you know? And I know that Target has a really cute one. I was looking online at them. So I'm hoping I can go and find that at our store. And then I'm gonna get some almond milk and a couple of other things that we need. And hopefully it'll be in and out, and I'm gonna come home and make dinner. Okay, so they had it at Target. How cute is this, right? It was $14.99, and it is a 19 pocket expandable file, and then it looks like this inside. So I'm really excited about this. I'm gonna probably like get it labeled and stuff. Shout out to Casey Holmes for having this on her vlog, because it really is going to be helpful. I'll get that in a little bit. And then I also got just this like little desk organizer. I have a bunch of different things that I have pens in right now, so I figured this could be one, you know, little thing to put pens in. It was like $8, I think, but I just think it's super cute and it'll look good in my office. And I can't forget, I got this really awesome washi tape to use to like label things. Like, I do a lot of samples for oils and stuff, so I can use this to like label the sample bottles. I totally forgot to show you guys before I put them in, but I just put them in. I was gonna roast the cauliflower crumbles too, but I decided to just cook those up on the stove and like toast them there. So I'm putting these on 425 for about 20 minutes, and then I'll check them and flip them if I need to. Also, I added some of the onion scraps and just other scraps that I had to these frozen chicken bones that I had from when I did the crackling chicken the other day. And I'm gonna fill this up so I can make a bone broth with it, like a homemade bone broth, pretty soon. Oh, and I just store this in the freezer until it's full. Here's what we've got so far after 20-ish minutes. I'm just flipping these and letting them go back in for maybe another 5 to 10 minutes. And here they are. I have the cauliflower crumbles on the bottom and then all the veggies here. I'm just gonna mix it all up and throw it into the lettuce wrap. I'm probably gonna use some of that ranch on it. My camera's about to die, but I will let you guys know how it is when I'm done. I'm so excited. It smells so good. Okay, so I just ended up using this as like a burrito bowl because the lettuce, when I opened it up, it just wasn't right. I used the cauliflower crumbles as rice and then all of the roasted veggies, and then I did about a tablespoon of the Tesmes creamy ranch, and then I did just a little bit of salsa. Oh my gosh, it was so good, you guys. Like, it was so good. This is definitely gonna go into like the weekly lineup. I actually think it's something that Alex would like too. He's very picky when it comes to vegetables, but he does like zucchini and peppers. He doesn't like onions, but he could try it. I mean, onions make everything taste better, okay? I'm just saying. This was so good though. It didn't have any meat, didn't have any cheese. I will say though, I bet it's really good if you add some like ground turkey or ground beef or ground chicken or something. I just wanted to keep it like all vegetables tonight. I don't know. Typically I would just use ground turkey though, you know? So you could definitely throw that in there and just really, I bet this could keep in the fridge for a while too. And it probably heats up nicely. Oh my gosh, it was so good, so good. So I just wanted to touch on a comment that I just got from somebody that has actually never commented on my videos before. One other time I was able to like look it up. But basically she said that she hates my videos because I tend to lecture everybody in my videos when I'm supposed to be vlogging, not being a life coach. And I mean, it kind of took me back, and I'm not even like, I'm not upset, I'm not offended, I'm just like, that's just not true. Like, I make these videos because I like to make them. Like, I love doing this. I love interacting with you guys, even if we don't agree. I mean, I know there are so many people out there that watch these videos that I talk to every day that we don't agree on everything, and that's okay. Like, we don't have to agree, but I'm certainly not trying to lecture anybody. I'm just trying to live my life on camera, you know? Like, I mean, I'm living 10 minutes of my day or 20 minutes of my day every day on camera and trying to share things that I've learned in the many ups and downs that I've had in my life. Or I am trying to talk through things for myself, and I'm gonna have this to be able to look back on later, you know? And so I just feel like if you watch every single one of my videos and you hate all of them, then why are you watching them? You know, like, I don't want somebody here that doesn't want to be here, please. Like, it's okay, you know, if you don't like me or you don't like the content or whatever. I'm not gonna change being who I am. If you sit down with me in everyday life, I'm not gonna just sit there and look at you. Like, we are going to probably have an in-depth conversation, a deep conversation, because I like to go beyond the surface. Like, that's just who I am. And I don't feel like I don't even feel like I need to defend myself. The bottom line is, like, when this stops being fun for me, I'm not gonna do it anymore. And it's only gonna stop being fun if I'm not myself, if that makes sense. And so I'm gonna continue to be myself. I'm gonna continue to talk about things that are on my mind on a day that I might be vlogging. And yesterday it just happened to be, you know, I'm sick of feeling like I need to live in guilt and shame, or other people need to, because like, people come to me every single day asking how they can change their life, and my answer is, you change it here. So I was just putting my thoughts on camera, and I'm not gonna apologize for that because it's who I am, you know? It's just who I am. So I'm gonna keep doing that. And here's the thing, one person out of all of you incredible people that has to say that, or they feel like they need to make somebody else feel bad, that's okay. Like, I'm not gonna, certainly not gonna let them bring me down, but I just felt like I needed to get this out too, because it's like, I just don't want this to stop being fun. You know, I mean, I stay up until 2 in the morning, sometimes 3 in the morning, editing these vlogs because I don't have any other time to do it, but I want to make sure that I have a video up. You know what I mean? And it's like, I don't want it to ever stop being fun, and I don't want it to stop. I don't want it to start being like this hateful thing, because I will not do this. I mean, I've seen people's channels that have just terrible, hateful people on them, and that is not what I want here. I would rather keep this tribe small and stick together and be filled with love and light instead of just hateful people that want to spew crap because they don't feel good about themselves, you know? So trust me when I say that if I need to stop doing this because it's not giving me happiness, then I will. I love this. Like, I can't explain how much I love interacting with you guys every day. But if it becomes a hateful internet place, I'm done. That's all I can say. But I just wanted to say thank you to all of you guys that support me and my thoughts and I guess my lectures or whatever it is on a daily basis. I certainly don't try to lecture anybody. I'm just trying to talk through my thoughts that I might have in that particular day.
On a fun little happy note, can we just talk about how cute this is? I love this, and I got all my pens and Sharpies in there. I'm totally a Sharpie person. I don't know if you guys are, but I totally am. And then I got my little rainbow notepad, my jar of happiness. It's like my little happy corner. I love it. And another happy note, this is the other peach palette, and this is how the winner will get it. If I can get it open, it's gonna come like this, just like it came to me. And I think it's awesome. Oh my gosh, it smells so good. But you guys know it goes till the end of the month, so just keep commenting and being kind and being nice to each other, because that's what this is all about.
Okay, you guys gotta help me on which ottoman I'm gonna get. The first one, I'm gonna just kind of zoom in here. This has little like studs on it. I don't know if you could see like little gems, and it's white, and it would go well in this room. You know, everything's pretty colorful, and then like, you know, white tables, white accents, those types of things. But like, you know, I have something like this. I have my really colorful couch, but I do really like this. Like, that's really nice. And then I saw this at Target a while ago before I knew that I needed a little ottoman, and this is like an iridescent like little ottoman, and I love it. Now this one is a little bit taller, and really it's the same size of my old one, which is what I like. The other one, this, the white one, is like an inch and a half shorter, so it would be a little bit weird probably to be sitting on, but I'll get used to it. I don't know, I just don't know which one to get. I love this though. It's like really funky, and I feel like it would match the room, but this one would too, and it could be used for something else later on too. This one would strictly be for in here. So what do you guys think? I don't know, I'm kind of leaning towards this one right now, but earlier it was the other one. I'm so confused. With certain things I can be so decisive, and then with things like a freaking ottoman, I'm indecisive.
Here's something else that makes me happy. This little sweet girl and this guy wearing the same pajamas as last night. Me too though.
I've got my rose hip oil on, which I'm still really loving. It's always so blurry out here. But I really love it. I feel like it's so like moisturizing and brightening. It's nice. I'm probably gonna go do another face mask too. It's what I do. You wanna do one?
That's fine.
Have you ever done a sheet mask?
No, I can't do that kind of thing on my face.
Why?
Not gonna be able to do it.
They're the best. You're missing out. He's giving me a look with his eyes.
What if it was a grape one?
No.
That's your favorite flavor of jelly, which is just wrong. Strawberry jelly is the best.
No, you're wrong.
No, you're wrong. You wouldn't do a grape face mask?
No, I don't like the idea of just something on my face. Like, if it's that painting one.
Which one? Oh, yeah, the glam glow in the T-zone.
I mean, I'm okay with that because it's not like on your face. You know what I mean?
Well, and the sheet masks are very creepy.
Yeah.
Do you want to do a sheet mask? You just want to lick yourself?
No, Mom.
Yeah, you're so sweet, Nolly. What are you... I think she likes the rosehip oil. She's always, like, licking my face and my hand after I put it on. Okay, I'm going to randomly dig through my masks and see which one I'm going to use tonight. Here we go. Bamboo. This one is moisturizing, refining, and firming, which actually sounds pretty good. So I'm gonna do this one. Obviously, I've never done the bamboo one before because the 16 pack that I got this in is like 16 different ones. So I haven't, there hasn't been one that has like completely stood out, like that's better than the others. I've done probably 10 of them already, and I really like them, as I talk about every day, but I will continue to because I think face masks like can change your face in a really good way. Like it just helps with the skin and moisturizing and everything. So I'm gonna do this one and go watch a couple of YouTube videos. Here's your daily dose of the creepiness. If you guys aren't taking a probiotic daily, you need to. I take one every night before bed. This is the Young Living Life 5. They also have a Life 9 now, but I just really, really like this one. Can we talk about the shadow of my bun back there? I just wanted to come and end this here tonight. Alex just jumped in the shower. I am so tired. I feel like today just kind of like rushed by because I got up so early and made so many moves this morning. And I also just wanted to like talk again about what I said earlier about like the comments and stuff. I kind of just listened to it back as I was putting it together a little bit. I don't want to sound negative, but at the same time, I'm going to be real too, you know? It's like, I always have that little bit of sass in me, but I just, like, I haven't even thought about it since I talked about it, to be honest. Like, it hasn't, like, ruined my day or anything. I just never want somebody to feel like I'm lecturing you. Like, I'm very passionate when I talk, and that's just how it is, and if it comes across that way, I don't know. I guess that's just how it is, but I literally do it because I know how I have felt, how I'm feeling, and how I probably will feel in the future just about things like that. And I just like to talk about it. I like to have an open discussion. I'm not telling you what you need to do or what you have to do or how things have to be, but I just like to have an open discussion. And I know most of you guys appreciate that and like that too, because I know like that's the kind of stuff that I like to watch as well, you know? But I'm gonna stop talking about that because it's like not even worth like talking about anymore. But I really, more than anything, like I say in every single video and I say every single day to everybody in my everyday life, I love you guys so much and I'm so grateful for this community here. It's just, I feel like now, like times like this more than ever, that's when I appreciate it so much more, you know what I mean? Because you guys are just incredible and I look forward to this every day, and that's how I always want this to be. You know, I want this to be so fun for all of us and somewhere that can be a positive and happy and enjoyable place to be on the internet, because we all know that that's not always the case for a lot of, you know, internet spaces. So yeah, thank you guys for being you, and thank you for what you bring to my life every single day. I love you guys so, so, so much, and we'll see you tomorrow. Love you.